Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Carbon here, bringing us today another brand new video. And in today's video, we're going to be talking about a new PlayStation update that is coming out tomorrow. Now, if you guys are Xbox One players, you can click away from this video. Obviously, this is not for you. But if you guys are PlayStation 4 owners, then this is definitely for you. You can stick around. We can discuss about the new PlayStation update. It's a PlayStation 3.5 system software update out tomorrow. So first off, this is the best feature ever. You can actually now appear offline. Isn't that awesome? You can actually still play online but appear offline, because this is actually definitely good for some of the YouTubers, because you know, when you're online, there's a lot of messages that you get, especially like the, you know, bigger YouTubers. You get a lot of messages online. That really doesn't happen to me, but you know, people keep bugging you when you're trying to play your game. So you could actually now appear offline and still play online. Isn't that awesome? So that's like the best feature ever, actually. It's such a simple feature that, you know, you probably would think that, you know, it should be there, right? But it is not there as of now, and they decided to add it, so which is pretty awesome. And then we have a friend online notification. So if your friends come online, it will send you like this message on your phone, stuff like that. They update the app tomorrow as well, so which is pretty awesome. And then we also have a user scheduled event. So if you have like a gaming party coming out, you can create an event and you can invite your player or invite your friends or whatnot, which is pretty good. I think it's a great way to have parties, so you can, you know, set the date and the time, and you know, everybody can, you can invite your friends, and then everybody can get together and play some video games. Alright, and then you also have this play together feature. This feature allows all members of a party to see what each person is playing, so that you can easily join a friend's game or start a new game together. Isn't that awesome as well? Alright, finally we have some remote play stuff going on here. We can actually now remote play PC and Mac. With this update, we're expanding PS4's and remote play capabilities to work with the Windows PC and Mac. Remote play on PC and Mac is compatible with the following system software. So if you have Windows 8.1, Windows 10 or later, and then we have the OS X 10.10 and then OS X 10.11. You'll be able to select from the following resolution and frame rate options depending on your internet bandwidth. So you have resolution options from 360p, 440p, or sorry, 540p, and then 720p. The default is 540p, but I guess if you have a better internet connection, then you can go all the way up to 720p. And then the frame rates are standard 30fps and then high 60fps. All right, then you can also use your DualShock 4 controller for remote play, so which needs to be connected to your PC, Mac, or you know, PC or Mac via USB cable. After the system software update launches, you'll be able to download the remote play installer from here. So there's like a little link you can go. I'll put the links in the description so you guys can go ahead and check this out. So like I said, along with the PS4's 3.50 system software update, PlayStation app version 3.50 is out as well, out tomorrow as well. The main new features of this update are as follows. So first of all, we have the user schedule event. So, you know, with the PS4's user schedule event, they also update the app as well to go with it. And also user can schedule gameplay sessions with friends, you know, whatnot. And daily motion has been added to live from PlayStation, and also other players shared activities appear in your activities. So these are some of the good features that are coming out to PlayStation 4, which is, I'm actually pretty excited for this, even though it is not a really, really big update, especially the appear offline. I'm really loving it. It's because sometimes, you know what, when you play a game, right, you just want to play at night, you know, peace and quiet. You need some, you know, peace, right? You just want to play your game by yourself. You don't want any interruptions, right? And then all of a sudden you get an invite from your best friend sometimes, right? You're like, hey buddy, let's play some video games. You know, you want to hop onto some Black Ops 3, but guess what? You want to play the campaign. You're still playing the campaign. You're going to finish campaign. And sometimes you don't want to say no, right? Because, you know, it's your best, he's your best friend or she's your best friend, and you can't say no. And so you're going to have to end up going and play with them. So this is a good opportunity, so you can appear offline. And I know sometimes, you know, actually one of my friends, his boss was on PlayStation networks with him, like on his friends list. So every time when he was actually sick, you know, sometimes when you're sick, you would play video games, right? I do that all the time. When you're sick, I mean, you don't necessarily have to be on the bed like 24/7, right? You can, when you have a little bit of energy, you get up, right? You get your medicine and whatnot, and you sit down, relax, and play some video games sometimes, right? Now the thing is, if your boss is on your PlayStation friends list, right, you can't necessarily play video games because he will eventually know that you are not sick. But even though you're sick, and there's no way to explain it to the bosses, you know, obviously that's how it works. So I think this is a good feature. Again, you can this can really be related to very different scenarios, and I think it's a great feature. So thank you so much for watching, guys. Let me know in the comments what you guys think about this new update. I'm hoping to bring you guys some awesome Black Ops 3 gameplay. Like I said, I'm currently working on a montage, but you know, a sniper montage, obviously. But you know what? I'm not very good at sniping, man. I can't get COD feeds or anything. I do have a few split COD feeds, but I'm trying to get a COD feed. I still haven't got a proper COD feed, and I was so close yesterday. I got 3 kills, and the 4th kill I hit marked him. Can you believe that? I hit market him, which really sucks. But anyway, guys, like I said, thank you so much for watching. Please give it a thumbs up if you like it, and I will catch you guys in my next video. Peace out, guys.